गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. सो नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द टॉपिक. नाउ रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन कैन बी डन एट टू लेवल्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल न्यूरल लेवल्स एज वेल एज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ केमिकल रेगुलेशन. इन न्यूरल वी हैव बेसिकली न्यूरल सेंटर्स इन द ब्रेन एज वेल एज इन द लंग. वी हैव मेनली पल्मोनरी रिफ्लेक्सेस विच आर अ पार्ट ऑफ न्यूरल रेगुलेशन. वेयर एज इन केमिकल वी हैव कीमोरिसेप्टर्स पेरिफेरली, which we will see in ahead in upcoming lectures that what they will do. Now continuing with the neural centers. So the neural centers concerned with respiration, in a broad ways I have classified them in, as in, suppose they are related to inspiration, related to expiration. What they do, whether they inhibit or whether they prolong inspiration expiration, we will see in upcoming. But as in whole, you can remember that pneumotaxis center of the upper pons and apneustic center of the lower pons are the two centers we will see concerned with inspiration. In medulla, on the same note, dorsal respiratory group and pre-Boxinger complex, which you all know is the pacemaker of the respiratory system, is in the medulla concerned with inspiration, and ventral respiratory group is concerned with expiration. Also remember, expiration normally at rest is a passive process, so you need not to have so much group of neurons to influence it. In only when there is forceful expiration needed at the time of exercise, then we will have the role of ventral respiratory group. Now we will see how inspiration are affected by this group of neurons. So inspiration, as we all know, to initiate we all activities we require a pacemaker. So pre-Boxinger complex serves as a pacemaker, then it stimulates, it goes to spinal cord and stimulates the phrenic nerve, and phrenic nerve in then does the diaphragm contraction. So this leads to inspiration as a whole in the initiation. Now this will lead to tidal volume 500 ml. Now once you have reached tidal volume of 500 ml, you need to maintain it at that level. So the maintenance is done by apneustic center, which in short apneustic center stimulates dorsal respiratory group of neurons, correlated in the previous slide in which we saw where are these centers located. So the apneustic center will promote DRG. So that dorsal respiratory group of neurons has a special function. They signal, the signaling pathway of them has a special function, and that is they do a ramp signal. What is ramp signal? Ramp signal is a gradual increase and gradual pause. So what happens due to this? There is inspiration, and this inspiration is maintained at our tidal volume of 500 ml. Now inspiration is sufficient. Now we need to terminate it. So for termination, you will have two centers, pneumotaxis center as well as vagal efferent from the lungs. Lungs gives efferents called the vagal fibers, and these go to the apneustic center, and this will inhibit apneustic center. And we all know that apneustic center was stimulating DRG, and this lead to the maintenance. But now since apneustic center is inhibited, there is no DRG, there is no ramp signal, and hence your inspiration activity gets a halt. And when inspiration stops, then obviously you will going to have expiration. And in expiration, we all know expiration is again a passive process. Only in forceful expiration you require the extra respiratory drive, which is provided by VRG. Now we will see what are the influence of pulmonary reflexes. Pulmonary reflexes, we all know, I told you earlier that in neural there was neural centers as well as pulmonary reflexes. So pulmonary reflexes are, first of all, overall four. We will see the first two. The first two are protective reflex. They are not much of regulatory reflex, they are protective reflex. So what happens? First is Herring-Brewer inflation reflex. In this, what happens when the normal tidal volume we know is 500 ml, so it has the capacity of three times the tidal volume. When your lung reaches the tidal volume of 1500 ml, there is hyperinflation of the lungs. This leads to overstretch, and the stretch receptors sense this. Now overstretch can again cause lung injury, and we don't want lung injury to happen. So that is protected in the body by this reflex, protective reflex, Herring-Brewer inflation reflex. So now your lung is hyperinflating. What you want now? Inspiration should decrease. So hence duration of inspiration decreases, whereas duration of expiration increases. On the same note, inflation reflex opposite Herring-Brewer deflation reflex. In this, there is prolonged expiration, and this again can lead to lung collapse, and you again don't want lung collapse. So you need to have protective mechanism, protective reflex, and that is HBDR. And in this, again, now you want expiration to decrease, so duration of expiration decreases, duration of inspiration increase. Now two more reflexes we will see. Head's paradoxical reflex. This is opposite of Herring-Brewer reflex, inflation reflex. Now in this, what happens that once your body is hyperinflating, it proceeds to hyperinflate. So this happens in newborn babies. What happens in newborn babies? That in newborn babies, initially their lung is filled with fluid, and now you need to convert that fluid into air. Hence the newborn baby shows head's paradoxical reflex, in which hyperinflation further stimulates hyperinflation. And the last very important is J receptors. The J receptors are located at a site, pulmonary interstitium, that is close to the capillaries. They, on initiation, basically, and these are mainly found in pulmonary edema. So what happens in pulmonary edema? If there is a blood vessel in lung, pulmonary capillary, the fluid comes out of it, and this now stimulates receptor that which is closely present to the blood vessel, that is J receptor. And why it is called J? Because it is juxtaposed position, meaning nearby to the blood vessel. Now what happens that this J receptor will stimulate your J reflex, and J reflex has an immediate effect of apnea, and then it will lead to breathlessness, hypotension, and bradycardia. So hence this is another reflex operating in our body. This is seen in pulmonary edema. So hence this is, in shortly, this is the crisp of the topic, neural regulation of respiration. Keep practicing more and more, and keep revising your concepts. And if you like this initiative, kindly subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you so much.